have made it to Lewistown, Montana. Here at the fairgrounds. At least this corner here. And they filled in a bunch of dirt in this corner over here in the right-hander. So it should be a lot more, flat right there instead of having that big old bank there. They tried to take out the bank in the on the entry of, let's say, this corner right here, the berm right here. They tried to take away as much of that as possible because it was getting pretty dangerous last year. They took away all that and they filled in a bunch more dirt down on the other side of the track. Nick set up there a couple of soft spots to go out and take a look because it rained off and on during the week, but nothing too major hit the track, thankfully, which is awesome. Right now we're just getting unloaded, got the cars teched. Austin doing a quick oil change, and since we just got the engine fired up on Thursday, so we want to do another oil change with it still breaking in, basically. I think Nick said the total is close to 40 we're gonna get probably by the time racing starts. And that's not counting, he said, that's not counting cars doing double duty in a couple of different classes. And we're just gonna stick with our class, super stock, BGM. Gets kind of spinny when you're trying to do multiple classes. But yeah, we're gonna go to check in, get our pill draw, so I can figure out where we're gonna start in the heat race. Just got done with hot laps and car felt great. Austin's car felt good. He doesn't have power steering though. He found a kink in the line. But yeah, hopefully do good. Start last in heat 4 of my heat. Austin starts 3rd in heat 1 and taking top 2. And we'll come back to you once we're all done with all that fun stuff.
Thank you.
heat races. Austin got fourth in his heat with no power steering. And he lost the tranny bolt. Pulled his transmission to the mount. So I guess we're going to ratchet strap it down so it doesn't come up, because he was hearing clank banging and clanking right next to him. My heat, I got second in my heat. Car felt great. It had a lot of power. It was hooking up. There's a lot of grip out there. I was right with the leader pretty much the whole time, besides maybe the last lap. Coming to the last lap, coming into this far corner here, car died on me. I threw it in so hard it died. So I fired it back up, and then I just kind of rode it out for second place. But still transfers to the A main, so I'm happy with that. Also, we'll start somewhere either in the middle. Should be in the middle of the B main, I'm pretty sure. Should be starting either the middle or the back, one of the two. He finished fourth. So, yeah. Or fifth. Yeah, should be starting probably fifth. But, yeah. Anyways, we'll come back after probably Austin's B main. We'll see. Give you a little update. And see you in a minute. Correction. We're going to use a chain to hold Austin's transmission on. So, a lot better than a rat strap, because we'll be less prone to snap. But since his lot was missing, I'm going to go and check mine and see, kind of do that little checkup, then do a fluid checkup, and then kind of go from there.
Thank you.
All done with all the races. Austin got third in the B main after running in second place. He caught the barrier. Caught this barrier. The sun was just right, and it blinded him. He couldn't really see it, and there was a whole bunch of dust too. But slammed it. It's all right. He still had fun even though that happened. I started 8th in the A main and drove all the way up to second place, catching leader. Just ran out of laps. Had an iffy. The start was a little fun. Me and three other cars were all battling out for, I don't know, like 5th place, 4th place. I don't know. Got a little damage from it, from that battle. But it was fun. Got all the way to second. Had a blast. Had fun. Finally able to get on the podium since that banner over there was made. You'll see it in the video, hopefully. I was really happy about that. But yeah, we had a good time. We're gonna get everything loaded up, cars load up, head back home tonight, and look over the front end of this thing, because I was pushing it so hard, and the front end kind of feels a little wonky, but yeah, it was fun. Hello everyone. Been a few days since the races now. Figure I'd do a damage report. What kind of damage we got now after running so hard. As you know, we got this little damage here from the start of the race. You didn't get it on video, unfortunately. But what caused this to happen was the two cars in front of me split. So I tried to go in the middle, and then it closed almost as fast as it opened up. So that's kind of what that did. Also, I don't know if you're going to be able to see it. There's a shock. We think that broke after loading it on the trailer, because we found one of the bolts just laying for that hold it on, laying on the ground. This corner, I just got to play surgery with it and zip tie all that back together. All that's not too much of a big deal, but the big issue is we lost a wheel bearing on the left. Some of it's still sitting in there, still got to clean it out, pop the old one out. But yeah, there's just ran fluid everywhere. So that might be a cause of some of the smoke in the video from my car. But we think it happened in the feature. So not in the heat race, but the axle has some scarring on it. Reclothed it, and we think it's all right to reuse, but I might just throw in this spare one in just to be on the safe side for the time being. But kind of just waiting on parts. That's where we're at right now. And yeah, just a few little things. Also got to move this back out. It got shoved in a little bit. This is kind of how we can tell that should be tight. So just pour a part of that bad boy back out and then call it good. But yeah, other than that, like I said earlier, the car ran great. And we're looking forward to the next race, wherever we might go. Don't know much on Austin's. Whenever he comes out again, he's got to get the rear end opened up so we can inspect everything, especially everything on this side. The axle on this side and whatnot. That's our spare axle. That's just kind of sick. The rim is... it might be salvageable, not sure, but this one, that one is no good from when he smacked the wall. So basically we need to get this tire off, get in onto a different rim. Thankfully, we have another rim somewhere. But whenever we get the chance, we're going to open that up, get this rear end opened up and kind of look and make sure the threads on that ain't all twisted. Thankfully, mine are good because my axle was kind of flopping a little bit. Not sure when, but whenever Austin gets here, we'll get that all taken care of and looked at. And other than that, like, comment, subscribe, share with your friends. Share the video with your friends and family, and we'll see you on the next one.